one. I hung up his portrait purely out of respect. Without him, there would be no genius society today. Frankly, I don't know what he has achieved. None of his books and inventions have survived. But there's gotta be a place for the founder of the society, right? Polka Cockamond, member 4 of the Genius Society. A woman full of mystery. Many people in the society died by her hand. I haven't heard anything about her for many years, but I firmly believe she is still alive. Hey, Lord of Silence, if you're here, if you're listening, I'm member 83, Herta, and I want to meet you. I believe you and I will have a lot to talk about. This is Aiden, member 22 of the Genius Society, the most selfless and the strangest one. He spent his whole life helping others. Personally, I don't see the point. But the Society is famous thanks to him. The Inter-Astral Peace Corporation has been trying to find a replacement ever since his death. They searched for many Amber Eras, but no genius was willing to lower their head to the IPC. Until they found me. Oh, Elias Salas, such a lovely old fellow. He is member 56 of the Genius Society, one of the only two publicly elected ministers in the Society's history. Be grateful to him. He created the Synthesia beacons and overrange remote sensing, the cornerstones of modern cosmic communication. However, he did not disclose his inventions to the public. So I hereby certify that the rights of these two technologies belong to the Intelligentsia Guild. To be honest, I'm not a big fan of the Guild, but it is impressive that they managed to reproduce Elias Salas's inventions. Member 76 of the Genius Society, Skrullum. I've known him for a long time. He's a really good man, a gentleman with an exceptional mechanical mind. I've learned a lot from him. Recently, I have been working with him and Ron May on a project. I hope this project can help us get closer to the greatest mystery of the universe. This is Madame Herta, or better known as Member 83 of the Genius Society. In her childhood, she solved the solitary waves theory and the spark model hypotheses. In her adolescence, she found the sigma baryons conversion method. In middle age, she proposed the Herta sequence and published a paper on de-aging. In her senior years, she managed to reverse her own age via de-aging and went on to solve the mystery of the imaginary leakage phenomenon and even captured and sealed a Stellaron. Madame Herta has saved the planet she was on from destruction 19 times and has met the eons twice. This space station is her property.
Hey, there you are. I haven't moved. What you're seeing is one of my remote-controlled puppets. They're all over the station. I just connect to one wherever I am needed. Enough chit-chat. I am working on a big project with a few colleagues. If we succeed, it will answer the ultimate question that's been puzzling us for thousands of Amber Eras. The truth about eons. Eons. Think about it. What mystical existences. Some eons used to be ordinary humans like you and me, but somehow they managed to obtain power beyond our imagination. They are mysterious, powerful, silent, and terrifying. It's hard to explain all the mysteries surrounding them. How were they created? Why were they created? What were they created for? Have you ever thought about these questions? To what? Are you even listening to me? We want to solve the mystery behind the eons. Right now, I want you to participate in this project. The four geniuses of the society wrote a program together. You see the big machine in the office? That machine contains a universe. Just like the universe we live in, but it's more streamlined and customized. I call it the metaverse. Oh, really? That's what my partner said as well. Fine. I am a team player. Then let's call it the simulated universe. Now go and experience it for yourself. I will guide you in the simulated universe to make sure nothing happens to you. I'll even give you a substantial reward.
It's too late to repent. Sufficient!
go.
Too late to repent.
We need a strategy.
Move carefully.
Stay right there while I give you a present.
Let's make it quick.
You can't run! You have the worst luck running into me!
Thank you.
It's getting late. Where to now? It's getting late. Where to now? Thank you.
step aside. I have no interest in...
Gotta try hard sometimes. Check out this awesome move! Look out! You have the worst luck running into me! With me out here, how can we lose?
Let's go.
Try that again. You can't run.
The time is now.
Reach the end of the story in your own way. We need a strategy.
Move carefully.
I don't remember inviting you. A gift from the stars.
The truth of life and death, revealed in an instant. This sanctuary is but a vision.
Watch this.
Let's make it quick.
What about this?
Clemency? Never heard of it.
A guest with no manners, huh?
My turn. Gotta try hard sometimes. Check out this awesome move.
Today.
You have the worst luck running into me. With me out here, how can we lose?
What about this?
Everything is ordained by the stars. Oh, profound secrets of the stars! Give these trailblazers your blessing!
Rules are made to be broken!
Step aside. I have no interest in stoking conflict.
Look out!
My turn. Stay right there while I give you a present. Huh.
gotta try hard sometimes. Check out this awesome move!
The truth of life and death, revealed in this sanctuary, is but a vision! It's too late to repent.
Inviting you.
You have the worst luck running into me. With me out here, how can we lose?
Let's go.
Better up.
Life and death, revealed in an instant. This sanctuary is but a vision!
Gotta try hard sometimes. Check out this awesome move!
When I was young.
step aside. I have no interest in stoking conflict.
I told ya I could fight. Watch this!
Let's make it quick.
How about this?
Reach the end of the story in your own way.
Shall we?
It's too late to repent.
I told ya I could fight.
Let's go.
Always welcome. Chill out.
The time is now.
Watch this.
Let's make it better up.
Reach the end of the story in your own way.
Thank you.
No need to get angry.
It's getting late. Where to now?
I think you're laying it on a little thick.
So? Have you thought things through? Go ahead, speak your mind. There's no need to be so formal. You helped us defeat that big fella anyway. Plus, if we keep making pleasantries, we'll waste a whole day. You've done me a huge favor by defending the space station from the Antimatter Legion. And know that while Herta may not admit it, she owes me one. She won't refuse me if I ask for a favor in return, and it's probably not too much to ask for a rare item from the space station, right? How about we continue talking on the express? I'll make you a cup of coffee. My special blend. I was ready ages ago. I've been here so many times before. It should have just been an ordinary trip for me. But everything's not so ordinary anymore, is it? Walking the same path over and over will never be the same. There will always be something new. That's the meaning of trailblazing. As always, to follow in the footsteps of Akivili. Sometimes we stop on other worlds, and we'll continue to do so. There are countless next stops in the galaxy. I love the vast reaches of space, and the Express does too. I want to seek out new worlds, and the Express wants to return to its former path. Because you're different. Well, that might be the biggest reason. It's not the only one. I think you need a chance. A chance to discover just how different you really are from everyone else. Everybody keeps telling you how special you are and how you have a Stellaron inside you. But that's already plain as day to you. And no matter who tells you, be it me or Herta or anybody, it's not the same thing as feeling it yourself. You have to experience enough to know if you've gained or lost anything because of the Stellaron, and to know who you really are. Learn to control the Stellaron, and then you can control your destiny. The Stellaron might still be an enigma, but the fact of the matter is, it's a part of you. And you have to embrace this before you can move forward into the future. So, have you...
I think you're laying it on a little thick.
It's getting late. Where to now?
people who buy that think smart water raises their IQ.
Hey, I heard the news. You're coming with us on the express, right? Do I even need to say it? I think we're becoming fast friends. Isn't that enough? But you look like you've got something on your mind. Come on, out with it. Getting nostalgic already? You know, when you were passed out, all I thought was I had to look after you. And then you picked up the bat? Just incredible! In the blink of an eye, you knocked that big fella into Mr. Yang's black hole and saved me. I still haven't thanked you properly yet. Nah, we're not splitting up here. I'd like to know too. I was already on the train when I woke up. I was just drifting out there in space and got picked up by the express. Amazing, right? Crazy stuff like that? Not too often. It sure freaked me out. But every encounter I've had since coming aboard the express has been strange, to say the least. For example, going to the desert to catch something called a sandfish, correcting a gravitational field to flip an upside-down castle, or almost getting my head cracked open by a Galena ball falling from the sky while trying to avoid a sleeping reindeer on the road. Huh. Looking back now, it all seems quite dangerous. But I had the crew there with me, so the problems didn't seem all that bad. Of course you should! Why wouldn't you? There's only four of us now, plus Pom Pom. Each of us can have our own carriage to sleep in. You wouldn't have the heart to leave your carriage unmanned, would you? Then come aboard and take a look for yourself. I'll be waiting for you.
I think you're laying it on a little thick.
try hard sometimes. Check out this awesome move!
Rules are made to be broken!
This is our team.
Keep at it.
Looks good.
Are you still in the mood to read a book?
It's getting late. Where to now?
So, have you thought things? Then come with me.
The way to celebrate.
Let's go.
I'll be waiting.
Time to get on.
Till we make it. Oh.
I'm over here.
Come with me, take the journey.